Hello everybody, this is Stratos Agiani from Illumius.com and today I'm going to show you how to erase anything that distracts the viewer's attention within the photo with the help of Affinity Photo. So if you watch this free tutorial, you are going to be able to erase anything that you don't like within your photos in a very easy way, but most importantly in a non-destructive way. Let's find out how we can do all these things after our fantastic intro. Welcome back everybody, Stratos Agiani here from Illumius.com, the website and YouTube channel where we publish free tutorials like this each and every week in order to help you get better in photography and build a business around the thing and the art that you love. So if you are new here and you like this video, consider subscribing because we are going to be publishing videos like this each and every week. I bet you have been there. You take a very nice photo and when you open the photo, when you return back to your home or studio, you are noticing some things that are distracting. For example, you can notice some things in the background, wires, some elements that shouldn't be there, etc., etc., etc. And usually the problem happens when you are taking a photo of something, let's say, and you focus all your attention at the center of the frame and you don't pay too much attention at the borders of the frame, and this is where usually problems tend to show up. And I'm guilty as charged of this. I sometimes do it even today, and I'm going to show you what solution I have found and how I can get rid of these distractions by using Affinity Photo in a very nice, smart and non-destructive way. So without any further ado, let's dive into Affinity Photo to see what I'm talking about. As you can see here, we have a photo open within Affinity Photo and there are some elements that are quite distracting and are moving away the attention from our portrait. Now, some people might say that this is actually not a distraction, the tree that we have on the left, because it adds a sense of place, because we can understand probably where this person is, but we are not going to go into that right now. We're going to assume that these distractions are actually distractions and I'm going to show you how you can get rid of them in order to have a very clean portrait. Now, the first thing that we need to make sure of is the first thing that we need to make sure is to be able to work without destroying our photo. So we don't want to go on this main background layer that contains our photo and start editing the original file. We want to do it in a non-destructive way. And in order to do so, we need to create a new layer by clicking here on the Add Pixel layer, and we are going to make sure that the new layer is above our photo. Next up, we're going to click here on the name of the layer and we're going to rename this empty layer Retouching, okay? Once we do this, we have to go over here, click and hold with your mouse in order for Affinity Photo to show this pop-up menu, and select In Painting Brush Tool. Finally, you need to make sure that the menu in this location is set in the option that says current layer and below, because if you use the current layer, you're going to start painting in order to tell Affinity Photo where to erase things and it's not going to do anything. So we need Affinity Photo to be able to sample materials from the current layer, which is empty right now, and below, meaning the original layer over here. Let's start with something simple. For example, I want to get rid of these people over here, which look like a blurred mess, and I want to actually erase them very quickly. What can I do? I can pick my Ink Painting Brush tool and left click and hold and move my mouse around in order to paint on top of the area that I want to be erased or corrected. Once I do this, I release the left button of my mouse and Affinity Photo is going to take care of everything. Right now it's running an algorithm that's going to determine from where it needs to pull material and where to place it in order to do the correction. And as you can see, the correction is very fast and it is perfect. Now, I can fine-tune the size of the brush if I want to work with something smaller. For example, if I want to get rid of this pole and this volleyball net, I can go and press on my keyboard the left or the right square bracket keys in order to make my brush smaller or bigger accordingly. So I'm going to press my left square bracket key in order to make it a little smaller, and I'm going to actually paint here. And I'm gonna wait in order for Affinity Photo to do its magic. Now, if you want Affinity Photo to work faster, you need to do the following two steps. Number one, you can plug your laptop on the brick charger. As you can see here, I'm using the battery, which is quite low, so it's taking a little longer for Affinity Photo to process everything because the CPU is running in a lower speed in order to conserve battery. So if you want to work faster with a laptop, you need to plug the laptop into the power brick, and also make sure that here on the power options, you need to make sure that you are using the high performance profile if you are using Windows. Just a small tip over here. Now, I want to get rid of this net completely, so I'm going to paint here in order to get rid of the top portion of the net, and also I'm going to paint here. Now, another tip is that if you're working with a lower resolution file, you're going to see that the inpainting brush is working a lot faster, okay? Actually, this process is quite fast, but you're going to see it going slow because I forgot my power brick at the office, so unfortunately I can't plug it in. Now, here, what we can do for this big tree? Well, we can work very quickly by increasing the size of our brush, and I'm simply going to paint over the tree over here, and I'm going to let Affinity Photo do its magic. Now, you're going to notice that as I'm painting, the edges of the brush are quite soft. This helps with the correction, because the correction is going to actually blend a lot better with the surrounding area of the photo over here, and you need to have this soft edge and soft brush in order for your edits to be able to blend in a realistic way with the rest of your photo. In order to achieve this softness, you need to go over here and you can select a hardness of 20% or more. This is going to give you a nice soft brush, so every time you paint within your frame, you are going to get a very realistic result, and the viewer is not going to be able to see where you have done any corrections. As you can see here, we have completely erased the whole tree. And for this area, which is quite complex actually, I'm going to do something else. I'm going to separate this area in small sections, and I'm going to click and paint in each one of them in order to be able to get better results, because the larger the blob or the area that you want to correct, the worst results you are going to get with this automated method. So if I'm going to paint this whole area and wait to see the result is not going to be ideal. But if you take small portions of the area that needs to be corrected and you keep painting like this, okay, you're going to get a much better result. Now that you have the grasp of how this tool works, I'm going to actually speed things up in order for you to be able to see how it works a lot faster, and I'm going to see you the final result after I finish all my corrections and edits. So, fast forward in 3, 2, 1, go! And we're back. As you can see here, we have done a pretty decent job on erasing all the distracting elements, but we need to make a nice correction here where the horizon lies, and in order to do so, I'm going to be using another tool, because if I use the inpaint tool, and let's try it, if I paint across the horizon over here, there are two chances chance number one, it's going to do its job and it's going to pull information from here, so we're going to have a nice horizon, which looks quite nice. Or if it doesn't work as intended, meaning that the horizon gets wiped out, you can go over here, you can select the patch tool, and you can click and hold and move your mouse around the area that you want to correct. Okay? And once you release your mouse button, you can move your cursor over here on the other side of the frame in order to tell Affinity Photo from where you want to draw material in order to correct the horizon on the left side of the frame. And since this looks quite nice, maybe I need to move a little higher over here in order to align the two horizons. I'm going to left click once more and I'm going to hit enter or double click, and Affinity Photo, it's going to do its magic. And as you can see here, there is a perfect correction on the left side of the frame. We have erased all the distracting elements and we have retained the horizon as well. So let's see a before and after. This is before, this is after, before and after. As you can see, huge difference for this photo, and it's artistic and let's say photographic side and value, because now the portrait is clear of distractions and the viewer is going to focus solely on the person within the frame. And if you want to see how the corrections look like, you can deactivate the background layer and you can see the layer with the corrections. Now, these are the corrections that we just did by using the retouching empty layer we created and dropped on top of the original photo. So there we have it. This is a before and after, before and after. Let's go to our fantastic outro in order to give you some more tips and advice on how to create distraction-free photos by using Affinity Photo. Okay, that was it for today. I hope this tutorial was useful. If you found any value, please consider subscribing to our YouTube channel. And also, you can go to illumis.com and get a whole course for free, in which I'm going to show you how to create amazing black and white cinematic portraits. Again, it's completely free because we are celebrating the launch of illumis.com, and you can go at illumis.com, find the free course and grab it for yourself while it's 100% again free. Thank you very much for your time. If you have any questions, please let me know in the comments down below. I will be more than happy to assist you in any problems you may have. And until next time, take care and happy raising.